Hey everybody, how's it going? It's Clippedshots here, back with another challenge run. This one is from Arc Lunar's Voidheart. He gave me a whole list of things, but I'm gonna kind of summarize it for you really quick. It's the Sadistic King, he calls it, where we have to take the Eye of Turtle, Matryoshka Shell, and Sappersack, along with the ohmygorb and ohmegorb, so that I can basically try to kill things before I run out of damage. So let's give it a shot and see how things go. It might go well, it might go poorly, and I don't really know. That was an easy first run. I can take only one Nosferatu, and as I go, I will only be able to, I will only be able to take ohmygorbs and ohmegorbs. I will take the Nosferatu now. Not that it really matters, because it won't deal any damage, so I can't actually heal myself, but having it just in the pocket will be really nice. I don't have anything that's going to stop me from getting... From getting more damage. Sorry, my brain went on like idle mode mid-sentence there. Let's go and upgrade an orb. If I upgrade this, that's not going to do anything. So we're just going to upgrade probably... Oh man, it's actually really difficult. These both have really good damage, but like, I'm going to go for the ohmygorb just because possibilities. And I actually might even go for this here in the middle. I'm gonna go to the right. I'm gonna keep going right until I can guarantee that elite fight, pretty much, because I want to make sure that I can get it. One of the things that I was supposed to do is I was supposed to get a mirror orb, but I cannot grab a mirror orb with how the game currently is. So we're just gonna duplicate a random one and ohmegorb. That's actually a really good orb to upgrade, simply because I want to be able to have damage and not completely get rid of all my damage. Unironically, I feel like if I can get a damage up, like a good damage up, not just like any damage up, but a good damage up. If I can get a good damage up, I think I'll be in a really good spot to get something like the Glorious Suffering, so that I can kind of balance out my damage. So we go and skip that, and let's go and just toss this. Literally anywhere this goes, it should be just fine. Okay, and that they're all dead, and this guy's dead as well. Let's go and upgrade again. We're again gonna upgrade the ohmygorb all the way to level 3, because if I'm gonna ever shoot him, I really want him to have that good damage. No, how did it? Okay, we're just not gonna talk about it. Let's just not talk about it. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day, by the way. If you haven't had a little sip of water or something to stay hydrated, please do so. It's usually good for you. Say usually. You never know what's what until it's what it is. I'm going to keep tossing my orbs off to the left here for a bit, because I don't really want to deal damage. I kind of just want to like get all the enemies to spawn in. And then once they're all spawned in, then hopefully I can actually do this and deal a bunch of damage. Maybe just get a bomb and we're good to go. I do need to heal. Obviously, I'm at 69 HP. And that's a good spot to heal. We can definitely just go right, but I kind of want to go left, because if I go left, then I can get a, get a guaranteed item. Well, not a guaranteed item. Get an extra event, possibly. So instead of going straight to the elite fight, duplicate an orb. Yes, I will duplicate the ohmygorb. We'll duplicate the ohmygorb. That was weird. Did I like move my hand a lot? Might have moved my hand a lot right there at the end. Okay. Again, we're just gonna kind of chuck it off to the side. Ooh, I don't really like this at all. Yeah, not super keen. I took them all out. Again, that's not gonna give us anything, so we're just gonna skip it. This one's fine to toss, and if it actually hits things, it's not a big deal, because you know, extra damage is kind of whatever. Okay, this one here, however, we will try to get it to do some crazy stuff, some good stuff. That's one bomb, and maybe that's not enough to kill him just yet. Oh, it is. Never mind. I lied. Intentional oboe. That's such a good item for this, because the intentional oboe is going to help negate the damage of the bombs, which means healing. It's kind of like a backwards way of healing. So we're going to go and take that. honestly, the Sapersack might be the one thing that helps us survive. Like, big, scary fights, I guess, maybe is the key here, right? Scary fights. Please, I would like to get one bomb. No. I cry. That's all right. We should be fine. This orb should do enough damage to take out. Oh, yeah, everything's dead. Yeah, everything's dead. I'm really hoping to get, like, a power glove or something. I really want something that's going to give us some extra damage. Yeah, let's go and upgrade one of these. Power glove would be really great. Or if I could get a ambidectionary, seal of conviction would be really great. I don't want the ambidectionary yet. I mean, sorry, seal of conviction if I don't have ambidectionary. So it's kind of all dependent on what I get here. Alrighty, this guy can just toss out. Go anywhere. Anywhere is fine, good sir. Anywhere is fine. Don't be scared. The world is your oyster. Two bombs, that's too many. Alright, let's go heal up again. Yeah, so we're in basically in perfect condition. I also kind of just randomly tossed that. I was like, oh yeah, I just want to go left here. Let's get down. Anyways, guys, I might be starting a playthrough, kind of, or just playing in general of Elden Ring. And I'm going to be probably doing that with one of my buddies. I know there's the co-op mod, and my buddy, he's interested in playing Elden Ring, and he's never played a Souls game before. So it's going to be super crazy. And if we happen to do that, I'm definitely going to share that with you guys, because I think it'd be really fun and really funny as well. Kind of just the whole nine yards. I can't believe he survived with 4 HP, sir. Can you just, like, get out of here? Can you just get out of here, man? There you go. That's two bombs. He's dead. The world's ended. We're good. We got the tree too, man. How did we get the tree? Why did we get the tree? Okay. Glorious Suffering is going to be fantastic, but it's also going to be horrible. So I think we just don't do that. If anything, a Cursed Mask actually wouldn't be too bad. Having extra damage is nice. Electropegnet, again, not too bad. But I'm scared of using the ohmygorb with the Electropegnet, because if we do that, what's going to end up happening is it's going to hit way too many pegs. Consuming Chalice is probably the one we're going to have to go for. It's the only one that in my head makes the most sense, because we're getting rid of pegs anyways, so refreshing isn't as important. Not only are we getting rid of pegs, but we're also making the board just more complicated all around. Okay, that's... Oh, there you go. There we go. That's way more than enough damage. I was gonna say that's kind of enough damage, but now it's way more than enough for sure. And that's fine. We don't actually have to win just yet. There you go. We just have to do a little bit of damage here and there. These are negative twos, which isn't great. Let's go ahead and upgrade. We'll upgrade one to level three, because it doesn't go past level two. So might as well have one really high level. And I just knocked off one of the buttons on my seat. So yeah.
Hold up. While it goes forward, let me look for it.
I found it. Haha. A weathered Peglin? No. Actually, I'll be honest. I'm kind of down to gamble. Kind of down to gamble a little bit. Because if we doubled our damage, okay? Hear me out here. If we doubled our damage. Oh man. Nah, I can't risk it. I can't risk it for the biscuit. Although with the change that it is, I should have probably risked it. Now that I think about it, I should have probably risked it. Because with the change that they made that you can't deal zero damage now, it's just 0.5 to 2. I actually kind of think that's almost better. Dang it. Why did I think about that sooner? Darn. I made mistakes, guys. The mistakes, they were made. Please get that crit. No. That's fine. This guy should be able to knock it all out. Should be able to. Maybe, possibly. Okay, maybe not. Really close, though. Really close. But not that big of a deal. We can actually heal here, but no need to. Because we're also, like, full HP. There you go. 1 HP! One HP! Get out of here. Get out of here. No one wants to see your one HP anymore, man. Get out of here. Okay, I want to go left here. I do really want to go left because I want to make sure that I grab as many items as I can. And this is definitely going to be the best way to do that, is going to all the chests and elite fights. I know you guys were telling me like, oh yeah, elite fights are better. And I'm fully aware that elite fights are better, but in comparison, you know, if you're going to, you know, not get any chest or get the elite fights, it's like, yeah, you probably want one or the other. Probably want something there. There you go. Hopefully we get like, yeah, one or two bombs is good. It'd be kind of cool if these orbs didn't get affected by their own damage reduction. I think that'd be like a nice like little thing. Okay, I'm gonna go and try to get rid of those pegs that I got to level -2. Kind of got rid of some of them. I got rid of a bunch of weird pegs there. That was like a bunch of random stuff. It was like, hello, how did you get all the way across the map? Okay, everything's dead. Yeah, everything's dead. Okay, heal up again, and down we go. So far, this challenge isn't too difficult, but that being said, I know that it's going to get very difficult here in a little bit. 5 pegs worth of damage can be really good, especially if I get a crit. I really hope that I get something that gives me more crits, because that would actually make this significantly better. 500 damage, that's beautiful. Kills everything here. And then the next guy, hopefully can kill this last guy. Yeah, he's dead. Okay, cool. That worked out brilliantly. No bombs needed. No bombs necessary. All right, let's go and start upgrading this guy, I guess. I mean, it's really difficult to say. No. Stop going the wrong way. It's going to be so difficult. Okay, it's going to be so difficult to go down the middle because I didn't actually clear out the middle like at all. Oh my. But yeah, if you guys are interested in that co-op playthrough of Elden Ring, just let me know. Like I said, I think this is going to be super funny. I think it's going to be super funny. It's probably going to be like highly edited and I'll probably try to stream a good majority of it. So if you guys are interested in that, like, that should be a thing that happens. That being said, I don't know. If you guys are interested in that, make sure to go to the description and look for my Twitch channel. Because if that's going to happen, that's where it'd be. Alrighty. I don't know where to throw this. Probably, like, here. Get rid of those pegs. There you go. Nice little bomb action. Honestly, everything's dead. So this next guy dies. Bing bong, we're good. Nice. Upgrade him again. Okay, this is where things get interesting. I feel like echo chamber is going to be the best option. If I could get healing, right? If I could get healing, then if the Wand of Sculptimate Power comes up, I could take the Wand of Sculptimate Power because I have healing and the oboe. But the problem with healing is I don't have that many. I'm not going to be hitting like that many pegs. At least this form of healing, it's not that good. Here's backpack, not that good. I only have like four orbs max and they're intertwined. So you don't get anything but like +1 or +2. And it won't actually help the Nosferatu at all. So, yeah. Echo Chamber though. Echo Chamber could actually help. I think Echo Chamber is the play here. So I'm going to go for the Echo Chamber. Okay, I want to go hard right, so I definitely need to just kind of work my way over there. Also, I guess this is a good spot to be. What? Oh, I kind of like it. Kind of like it. Because, what's it called? I have the intentional oboe. I do, but I don't. I'm not going to take it. If I took it, it would be the wrong play. I know it would. I've done it before. It would be bad. It would be bad, I promise. Okay, I can't click out there, apparently. That's unfortunate. Sorry, we'll go down the middle. We'll get the fight anyways. We'll just get one less. We filibuster. That literally probably does nothing for us. Like, maybe 10 damage. Maybe. It's going to be a very minute amount of damage. If any at all. Okay, this guy shouldn't be too bad. Let's hope and pray I can get that crit down there. There we go. 500 damage. That's half his health. +300. Yeah, he's basically dead now. That's nothing to worry about. Yep, he's dead. Okay, cool. That was good. I am very concerned. I am very, very concerned. Ooh, that's nice. Oh, but double crits. Yeah, we're definitely going for that. You have to go for that. And the reason why you have to go for that one instead is because I only have one refresh on the board. Having more crits means that's double the crits instead of one. It's going to rat the Peglin Chef out. This is actually really good. We get an extra fight here. Like, this isn't a fight that I normally would be getting. So getting this fight is amazing. And I hope I just go straight down. Please, please. Yes, perfect. Wow. That was super good. I'm just going to kind of toss it over here. Not really expecting it to do much, although it did kill him. Maybe. Oh, a 10 HP. That's fine, sir. You can stay alive with 10 HP. I don't care. Hopefully I get that bomb. Oh, please. Okay, no bomb. That's fine. This right side is fully clean, though, so I can just go and toss this guy in here. And hopefully get a crit. There you go. 500, 600 damage almost. Bing bong. They're both dead and gone. This guy, no reason to fire him. Although, if I don't fire him, I take the damage anyways. That's fine. That's all we needed to do. That bomb took care of him. Okay, I guess we start upgrading. Overwhammer, unnecessary. Puppet, prevent the first time you lose health. That could actually be really good. I'm gonna take the puppet. I mean, not taking damage one turn could just be really good. Oh man, I almost snaked it in. Almost snaked it in. It was really close. Okay. Definitely not this. Wow, we are unfortunate right now. You know what? Yeah, you know what? I will toss it first. Because ideally, I want to have like an empty space that I can maybe possibly not kill too many pegs. So we're going to go and toss this guy out to the right like this. Like I said, hopefully I don't kill too many pegs here. There you go. That was a pretty good number. Now I can toss this guy in here somewhere and hope that he gets, first of all, a refresh. Second of all, a crit. Yeah, we got a crit. Okay, that's the important part, getting the crit there. Please get a refresh too. That'd be fantastic. Yes, nice. 1300 damage plus a couple bombs. I mean, that's mad damage. Yep, he's more than half HP gone already. That's beautiful. I mean, we are doing phenomenal right now. Another 1300 damage. Beautiful. Yeah, okay, we're good. We can toss any orb now. Anywhere, any orb. Any which way you look at it. Because he's going to be dead here anyways. So, this is fine. This is fine. There you go. Upgrade. Everything's upgraded fully now. Now, again, I kind of wish we had one ultimate power here. That'd be pretty nice. Something like this would be really nice. I don't have anything that's increased my damage yet, really, except for consuming chalice. And this would basically completely negate consuming chalice, which I'm not really fond of. I don't mind the idea of the gift. Mainly because this guy tears through them anyways. But having extra flat damage, I think, is going to be the better option. And, oh man, it's really, this one's really difficult. I'm going to go for Cursed Mask. I'm gonna go for the Cursed Mask. I haven't taken that in a while, but I do feel like that's probably the right decision here. And it still does what I thought it does. Orbs get +2/+3 while you have a negative status effect. So it gives us Confusion, which is a negative status effect, and lets us go crazy for a bit. There's two bombs. They're dead. Right? Yeah, they're dead. Nice. Heal up. And move on out. Again, I still wish it would get rid of this. Like, I've already done a turn. Like, the combat's over. I could literally just sit and wait until that's out. But nah, it's like, nah, bro, you don't get to get it removed. Are you crazy? I also like this concept where I hit one side and it hits the pegs on the other side, but doesn't actually destroy them. I think that's a cool concept. Okay. That's gonna go in the fire, isn't it? Oh, it didn't. Wow. What a champion orb. Just absolutely avoided everything. Okay. definitely don't want to use that. This is a good one to use. Not bad. Nice thing is we got that crit. So big damage already. That's 18 damage per peg. I mean, that's almost as much as a normal bomb. Almost as much. That's also why I would say bombs are still stronger. Alrighty, and then gone. Heal up, and again, direction here doesn't matter because there's only two sides to this route. So it's either you get one or the other. But here will matter. We want to get all those chests. Chests. Really can't speak. I almost feel like I have a lisp right now, and I don't know why. Don't know why, but I feel like I do. Just like slightly. Just like on the tip of my tongue. Something's not right almost. Alrighty. I still don't need to use that guy. I definitely got rid of too many pegs here, but not a big deal. Because that bomb got him. This guy's almost dead. And then we just toss it out and anything kills him. Just like that. Magic. He's gone. Heal up. And oh, we are... This could be difficult to get. Yeah, I would say we're probably not going to get that chest. I didn't realize that we cleared out the left side so much. But hey, you know what? Oh, look. That actually works out even better. Unironically, that worked out even better. I guess everything happens for a reason, right? 400, let's go. I was hoping that we would get something that was better. Nice, okay. Nice, get him, yes. 500 damage. He's pretty hurt, 300 left. Oh no. Okay, that was not a great shot. It's really difficult to get a good shot here, but we just got him, so we're good. Heal up. Nice. Those also refreshing the board would probably be better. Chicken? Oh. I don't even know what to grab right now. What's our boss at the end? Is it the QR code? Yeah, it is the QR code. Okay. Dang. Okay. So the chicken's probably not that important because we have a lot of AoE things slash things that can carry over damage. So really just anything that gives me more crits. I think he's going to be the best option. So we're going to go for that guy. Even though it's only one extra crit, it's still more. I knew that was going to happen. It's fine. This game giveth and this game taketh. So let's just count our blessings. Well, sheesh. I'm going to go and skip it. I'm going to go for this guy first so I can maybe clear out the board a little bit and hopefully deal a little bit of big damage here. Hopefully these guys are taken care of, and then the next guys, yeah, those guys take care of. There you go. Nice. That works out beautifully. There's a bomb. I think he's dead, and then the next guy's dead too. Yeah, that worked out perfectly. Okay. Heal up. Definitely far left if we can. So let's see if we can kind of snake our way down there. This is kind of a gamble. This literally goes anywhere it wants to go. But it is more likely to go to the left side because the last path is going left. I don't know if that makes any sense, but the last path is going left. Let's enter that tear. Yeah. Forest boss. This should be an easy fight. Yeah, considering we've also already fought him and won, I feel as though it should be easy now that we're at the end of the road. Yep, he's dead. Okay. Nice. We didn't even get any bombs. Beautiful. I almost killed the tree too. Okay, this one's not too bad. Every reload grants plus one balance. That's actually really nice. Persist, ring of reuse is probably the worst item. So never grab that. Yeah, we're gonna get the shrewd scales. Cause if anything, we can kind of force that a little bit. We can kind of force it a little bit. So ideally that's what we're gonna do. Is force the reloads, if necessary, of course. Bad cheese, that also goes with the reloads. So I can't really complain. Yeah, far left we go. Also, guys, I don't know why, but let me tell you what I had for breakfast. I don't know why this came to mind, but it did. What I had for breakfast, I decided to make something kind of random. I wanted something that's gonna give me some protein, and I just wanted something different, like something that I don't normally eat. So what I did was I got like some big globs of what's that called? Dang it, my brain isn't functioning the right way. Some big globs of peanut butter, and then just got a banana and chopped it up and put it in there with it, mixed it all together and ate it. It was like, it doesn't sound like it's gonna be that good, but it's actually pretty good. I would definitely recommend it. Like, if you guys just want like some good food, like a good easy breakfast, that's definitely like a good easy breakfast. Obviously, you know, you gotta be a little bit careful. You don't wanna have too much like fats or whatever, but hey, you know what? I think that's fine. Wow, I'm getting that bad luck there, eh? I finally cleared out a side though, so that worked out. I got a lot of damage from it. We could totally heal here. Here wouldn't be too bad to heal. Let's see what we can do though. Let's see what kind of damage we can do. Nice, they split up. That was actually the best thing they could have done. Get that refresh? Yeah. I love getting refreshes like that. It's always super nice. I'm just gonna go for this guy and see if maybe we can get crits and stuff and just really eat up the board and just do enough damage to just take everything out. Not quite. Let's try it again, round two. And he's dead. Nice. That's all that really matters. The quicker we kill them, the better off we're gonna be. This is really good. Peg bag is really good because it gives us two more crits. That's why I got the that was part of the reason why I got the heavy shaft potion or light shaft potion. Light shaft potion. So I got the light shaft potion. Cause see, a refresh also grants crits. So, oh look, here's the mirror orb. So we finally got a mirror orb. Refractive fragment. What am I saying? Guys, help me. Words. They're not coming out of my mouth properly. I'm saying just a bunch of garble nonsense. Okay. Well, here it doesn't really matter where we toss it because there is a bunch of enemies up front that need to be taken care of first, and it's gonna take a little bit before we get those. But now it's actually gonna be really good because now what we can do is deal the damage across the board. This enemy here probably at this point needs like 2,000, maybe 3,000 damage, and we did 1,000. So this guy's still alive. Let's see what we got here. He might be dead here. Yeah, there you go. Told you he might be dead. Ooh, okay. That's actually really nice. The power glove's really nice. I kind of want a power glove, to be entirely honest. This is cool. Bessie's hedge is cool. But I'm built for crits. So anything that gives me more crit damage is kind of better. And I say I'm built for crits because of the consuming chalice. So that's definitely the winner there in my eyes. Especially because refreshes and crits give us crits. I mean, hey. Hey. Alrighty. This is gonna be interesting. Usually you wanna hit this bottom one first because that bottom was like really important to hit. And I really wanted to fire it there. I'm gonna wait till this cube comes back. Hopefully it's in the right rotation again. Not really in the right rotation, but hey, it kind of works out. We're probably not gonna one-shot this guy. Yeah, not enough damage to one-shot. But we are gonna do a lot of damage here. Yeah, there you go. This one, we could do a two-shot, though. Let's wait for this cube to come to the bottom left. Or this one, actually. Either way works. This one for sure, yeah. There you go. If we get 2,000 damage, we win. Actually, we won already. Nice! Yeah, that's the power of power. Just give me as much damage as I can get. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to leave a comment, subscribe, and catch you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for the challenge, and adios!